time seems to have a way of taking its toll on everybody. Called this one poetry, yes. A fellow said the other day that he knew what poetry was, and he defined it pretty well. To him, it was fire and rain, pain and joy, the storm of language. Oh yes, there was love and lust and no particular respect of rank, but the flowers were overlooked. Now his was a reaction to what someone else said poetry was. Cut and dried feelings in a frame, tidied up for the universal now that we all intellectually share. A point of view that has merit for some, but not all. Over by the church tower, there sits a lady who rhymes couplets and quatrains in archaic word order to praise God and nature in gentle, worshipful tones. Love for her is simply scansion divine, and she likes her own verses just fine. In academia, professors poke the bones of rhyme schemes and tick away at meter and beat, determining what students have learned about fitting emotions into glass houses built by rule and level and discipline. Meantime, black kids syncopate rap. Country boys and girls write ballads. City youth look for harmonic lines that blend with weighted metal. Serious types tinker with computers, looking for access to the ultimate database containing schemata that defines the essence of the beat, and the whole crowd is picking and humming and tapping and scribbling thoughts onto scraps of paper or bits of hard copy. Out of that furious noise, which you must understand is not all bad, comes that sweet thing that we talk and read and sing, that stuff we call poetry. Us midnight lightning rods, ballpoint pen burners, keyboard insomniacs, forest killers, us poets, continue doing our craft without much definition or great encouragement, turning the sounds of words into moments of art, to speak, to hear, to dream, to preserve old rhythms and explore new channels of emotional intercourse from century to century. Is an ancient and honorable calling, greater than we might first guess, but it provides the answer to every definition of poetry. Yes.